I was stronger in my head, but truth is I need your grace.
I need your
hands together. Woo. Every promise concerning your life shall come to pass. If you believe that, say amen. If you believe that, say it louder, amen. Woo. I hear the sound, the abundance of rain. That means my blessings are on the way. May not see it, but I do believe it. The promises of God are already mine. Say,
I hear the sound, the abundance of rain.
That means
my blessings
are on
the way.
May not
see, but really do believe it. The promises of God
are already mine. Yes.
Already mine.
I believe.
It's
already. already. Already mine. Already mine. I believe. It's already mine. If you believe the blessings of the Lord are yours, would you jump those hands together for Him? Woo!
I hear the sound,
the abundance,
of rain.
That means
my blessings
are on the way.
May not see it,
but
really do believe it.
The promises of God are already mine.
Promises of God.
mind, without the piano, the voices.
If God said it, I believe it.
I'm gonna stand on His word
until I receive it. I hold on to His every word. The promises of God.
One more time, if God said it.
If God said it, I believe it.
I'm gonna stand on His word until
I receive it. I'll hold on to His every word. The promises of God.
It, you'd rather hold on it, hold on to it, because His word will not fail. This morning, God will speak to your life. I said, God will speak to your life. Let's rise to our feet. The Bible says in the book of Hebrews 11, verse 20, by faith, Isaac blessed his children concerning things to come. The Lord has prepared His servant. We have a father in the house this morning that will bless our life concerning 2021. And I believe the prophecy will not fall to the ground. You will go with your prophecy being fulfilled in the mighty name of Jesus. By the prophecy of God's servant, our father in the house this morning, your life will not run empty. This year, it shall be abundant of blessing in Jesus' name. Can we welcome our father, Reverend Dr. Isaac Oriakhi?
I believe it. Until I receive it, I'll hold on to His every word. The promises of God.
Hallelujah. If the promises of God, they are already ours, the service don't close now. Praise the Lord. This is our year of restoration. Therefore, whatever made you cry last year must bring you joy this year. The place you fell last year, you will get there, you will not fall this year. Before I preach, we have three prayer points to pray over. Number one, all those who have been fighting your destiny from fulfillment, this year they lose their power. They lose their power. Repeat after me, say, oh God, all those who have been fighting my destiny to hinder fulfillment, this year they lose their power over my life in the name of Jesus Christ. Make it your prayer.
They lose their power over my life in the name of Jesus. Any power that has been fighting my destiny for female in the name of Jesus, this year they lose their power. Legebos, 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 They lose their power. Legebo shada da da da. Legebo shada da da da. Legebo shada da da da. They lose their power. They lose their power. They lose their power over my life. They lose their power over my destiny for female. They lose their power. Leke, ledozo, legedos, liga da 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 da, liga da 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 da, liga da da da, liga da da da, liga da da da, lebo shada da da da. In the name of Jesus, they lose their power. They lose their power. They lose their power. They lose their power over my life, over my destiny.
In Jesus' name, we pray.
Amen.
They have lost their power.
Amen.
Number two, no one shall stop your star from shining this year.
Amen.
No one shall glory in your glory.
Amen.
The meaning of that is you were supposed to be here, but somebody will push you out. You were supposed to be on that journey, somebody will knock you off. You were supposed to win the contract, but somebody else took over. Anybody that wants to glory in your glory or stop your star from shining, push them out.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Christ. Prayer.
In the name of Jesus, no power, no power, no power will stop my star from shining this year. In the name of Jesus, my God, my God, I take authority this morning against any power that want to stop my star from shining. I push them out. I push them out. I push them out. I push them out by fire, 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 by fire. Whoever that want to stop my star from shining this year,
in Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
You have tried, but you have not prayed enough. Do you know the meaning of somebody stopping your star from shining? Do you know the meaning of somebody glorying in your glory? That means where you should have been number one, they make you number two, number three. Somebody is always ahead of you. You will be like that man, impotent man at the pool of Bethesda. When they took him there, they thought within a few days he would be out. He ended up spending how many years? 38 years. And when Jesus said, will you be made whole? He said, Lord, I have no man. When I'm trying to move, another will get ahead of me. That's somebody glorying in your glory. Somebody stopping your star from shining. You are going to pray that prayer again. Shout it loud. Oh God.
Oh God.
No one shall succeed.
No one shall succeed.
This year. To stop my star.
To stop
from
my star
shining.
From shining.
No glory in my glory.
No glory in my glory.
In the name of Jesus
in
Christ.
In the name of Jesus.
Prayer.
They will not succeed. I have a shalegede. Lekadok skuga. Lebekedekede. Lekedekede. 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 They will not succeed. Ah, my God, my God, my God. No one will glory in my glory. No one will stop my glory. I mean, glory in my glory. They will not succeed from stopping my stand from shining. In the name of Jesus.
In Jesus' name, we pray.
Amen.
Finally, the third prayer. Oh Lord, reorganize my life this year so that I will gain fulfillment. Let God reorganize. Let God redirect. Let God restructure. Let God put in place your life in such a way, fulfillment will be the normal thing in the name of Jesus Christ. Prayer.
Oh God, in the name of Jesus, this year 2021, oh God, reorganize, rearrange my life, oh God, to get to the place of fulfillment. In the mighty name of Jesus, my God and my Father, the rearrangement that will take me, oh God, to the place of my fulfillment, let it take place in my life. Let it take place in my life. Let it take place in my life. Oh God, this year 2021, lekabo shada, 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 lekabo shada. Rearrange my life. My God, rearrange, oh God, my life this year.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Sing this song with me before I preach. Oh Lord, what a wonderful God you are.
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 What a wonderful God you are. Oh Lord, what a wonderful God you are. Because you are wonderful, we believe. Your word, your promise to us this year shall be fulfilled. We shall swim in your love. We shall swim in your grace. We shall enjoy your goodness. And we shall be testifiers of the wonders of God in the name of Jesus Christ. This morning, Father, speak to our hearts again. Cause your name to be glorified. Use me as your instrument. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. I found a passage in the book of the Psalms, Psalm 8. The psalmist made a discovery. Psalm 8 from verse 1, I'll read on to 4. O Lord, our God, how excellent is thy name in all the earth, who has set thy glory above the heavens. Verse 2. Out of the mouths of babes and sucklings has thou ordained strength. Take a look at this very well. Because of who? Thy enemies. That thou mightest steal the enemy and the avenger. The psalmist said, the glory of God fills the heavens and the earth. even from the mouths of babes and sucklings. He ordained praise and he says God put forth his strength into action because of his enemies. Unknown to you and me, there is a battle, the battle of the gods. We are not involved. We only happen to be the grasses that suffer where two elephants fight. God created man in his image and set us forth to have dominion. And because of the rebellion of Satan, Lucifer, he decided he will spoil this program of God and make a mess of what he called power. And that's what the Bible is saying here, that he has ordained strength because of his enemies, that he might steal, shut the mouth of the enemy and the avenger. When God visits you, when God blesses you, when God causes turnaround to take place in your life, he is mainly shutting up the enemy. Telling him, I told you, you cannot achieve it. When he worked on Job, it was the same thing. When Sarah eventually had a child, it was the same thing. So I want to assure you this morning, whatever battle, you will overcome. With God on your side, in the name of Jesus Christ. Verse 3. When I consider the heavens, the work of thy fingers, the moon and the stars, which thou hast ordained. Verse 4. What is man that thou art mindful of him, and the son of man that thou visitest him? The psalmist said, I have taken time to consider your works, and I have discovered if it is glory, there are many creatures of yours to give you glory. You can do without man, but why are you so much particular about man? Brethren, I want you to understand that the reason why God is showing us so much love, the reason why God is bringing about so much care, is because of the covenant. The covenant. That's why he's committed. That's why he has been in the business of restoration. And I want you to please understand this morning that God himself said, my covenant will I not break. I will not alter the thing that has gone out of my mouth. That's where we draw our strength, our confidence, our inspiration. And I want you to know, please, that if God so loves and cares for us, he has shown so much commitment. The question is, why is it that many of us are not enjoying what God has provided? Why is it that many of us are battling unending? Why is it that we move from trouble to trouble, from trouble to trouble, year in, year out, and no rest? By the grace of God, we shall be making some discoveries here this morning. That's why I'm speaking on the topic, pointers to restoration. Pointers to restoration. Because God will work with those who have the right to stand before Him. God will work with those who have the right to stand before Him. I want to let you know, we can live the best of our lives this year because God is out to do the work of restoration. Praise God. Point us to restoration. What do I mean by that? I wouldn't want the year to end and then you are looking for dictionaries to understand the meaning of restoration. Because you cannot see the evidence of restoration in your life. Restoration is telling us that God will bring back, no matter how far it has gone, what we have lost. Restoration is saying God will correct and put in place the way it should be everything about us. Restoration is saying that God will bring you to fulfill what He designed you to be. That the enemy altered and He repackaged. God will bring you back to that original purpose. And I'm believing God. Before you walk out of this hall today, you'll be so convinced that restoration is possible in the name of Jesus Christ. You will not behave like Sarah, who when God came to her house and told her about the restoration work that is taking place in her life, and that within the new year she was entering, that the story will change. And she started laughing. And our pastor told us last night, attitude. Attitude. The way you respond to what God is saying. Hebrews tells us, the word preached did not mix with faith in them that had it. And so, they couldn't get fulfillment. Attitude. So come with me. Genesis chapter 37. I read from verse 1. And Jacob dwelt in the land wherein his father was a stranger, in the land of Canaan. 2. Make it fast. These are the generations of Jacob. Joseph, being 17 years old, was feeding the flock with his brethren. And the lad was with the sons of Bilhah and with the sons of Zilpah, his father's wives. And Joseph brought unto his father, what did he bring? He was able to bring the evil report because he was not part of the evil. You cannot correct a problem you are a part of. You'll be an hypocrite. One of the reasons why we have leaders and nobody listening to them is because they are part of the problem. He brought to their father their evil report. This is one first thing we are knowing about Joseph. That at the age of 17, he had taken a position in life that he will walk with God. He will be his best for God. He will not allow anybody influence him negatively. He brought to their father their evil report. Verse 3. Now Israel loved Joseph more than all his children because he was the son of his old age. And he made him a coat of many colors. Verse 4. And when his brethren saw that their father loved him more than all his brethren, they hated him and could not speak peaceably unto him. But let me say this. The love of the father was available to all. But the one that walked his ways into the heart of the father got the love of the father. All the disciples of Jesus had access to lean on Jesus Christ. But only one made that choice. His name, John. And everybody started calling him John, what? The beloved. Not because Jesus said to him, I love you more than others. No, he walked his way to that position. I want to ask you this morning, where will you walk your way to? There are pointers to restoration. When those pointers are there, it's like you are going to a particular place and there is an arrow pointing that this way leads to that place you are going. If you follow the arrow pointing to the place, you will get there. But if you disobey the arrow, there is no way you can be there. That's what the pointers will do. Verse 5. Verse 5. And Joseph dreamed a dream and told it to his brethren, and they hated him. What do you see there? Yet the more. Yet the more. They hated him, yet the more. Verse 6. And he said unto them, here I pray you, this dream which I have dreamt. 7. For behold, we were binding sheaves in the field, and lo, my sheaf arose and also stood upright, and behold, your sheaf stood round about and made obeisance to my sheaf. Verse 8. And his brethren said to him, shall thou, what word do you see there? Indeed. Why indeed? Because something happened before. Only princes wore the coat of many colors. Princes. For their father to make a coat of many colors and give to Joseph and not to Reuben, everybody started suspecting. This one is who? A prince. A prince. Why did Jacob do that? Because he separated himself from the evil report, evil dealings of his brothers. Praise God. He walked his ways into the heart of their father. He knew what their fathers loved, what their fathers enjoyed. He walked his way into that. And their father was so happy with him. And he said, you will be the prince. The way I am seeing you, you will carry this family. The way I am seeing you, you will be a blessing. The way I am seeing you, the hand of God is upon you. And he made for him a coat of many colors. Rise up, let me speak into your life. This morning, I pray for you that something will happen in your life that God will make you special. That man was saying, I have no man. Stop complaining, I have no man. I have no this. I have no godfather. Which godfather when you have the Almighty? From today, I declare, you will fulfill destiny. Sit down. Genesis 39. Verse 1. And Joseph was brought down to Egypt. Jealousy made his brothers to sell him into slavery, because they said, shall we indeed? So this coat of many colors is not a joke. Shall we indeed be your servants? No. We must do something about it. And they repackaged him, sold him into slavery. And they said, we shall see how his dream will come to pass. And Joseph was brought down to Egypt. And Potiphar, an officer of Pharaoh, captain of the guard, an Egyptian, bought him of the hands of the Ishmaelites, which had brought him down thither. Verse 2. And the Lord was with Joseph. May God be with you everywhere you go. One down payment you can make this day is to do everything to make sure God is with you. Then you are set for everything good in life. And the Lord was with Joseph, and he was a prosperous man, and he was in the house of his master, the Egyptian. 3. And his master saw, may people see things in your life, that the Lord was with him, and that the Lord made all that he did to prosper in his hand. Verse 4. And Joseph found grace in his sight, and he served him, and he made him overseer over his house, and all that he had he put into his hand. Verse 5. And it came to pass, from the time that he had made him overseer in his house and over all that he had, that the Lord blessed the Egyptian's house for Joseph's sake. And the blessing of the Lord was upon all that he had in the house and where? In the field. Please look up a little. Whether you are doing your personal business or you are working for somebody, when you pray, pray that God will bless that thing. When you labor, labor for blessings to come. When we have the right attitude, when you are accustomed to right attitude, doing things right, whether it's your own or another, I want to tell you, the Bible says, if you have not been faithful in that which is another man's, who will give you that which is your own? Joseph was very faithful. The blessings were coming. He wasn't jealous. That is because I'm a child of God. That's why things are working this way. Before I came, it was not like this. Let me diminish my commitment to God so that his blessings will reduce. After all, he's an Egyptian, he's not a Jew. He too will have decreased. When you labor for the promotion of others, your promotion will follow. Verse 6. And he left all that he had in Joseph's hand. And he knew not aught he had, save the bread which he did eat. And Joseph was a goodly person and well favored. Please underline that aspect. And Joseph was a goodly person and well favored. When we talk of pointers, we are saying reasons why God will do, honor, fulfill your covenant desires. Why will God bring restoration in your life, in your family? Do you know, if you've been married and no child, after 1, 2, 3 years or more, that this year it can happen? Because this is the year of what? Resurrection. Do you know, if you have been struggling to establish a business and nothing worked, even now you do not have capital. Do you know that even without capital, God can establish that business for you this year? Why? Resurrection. But the thing is, there must be pointers. Reasons why God must bring to pass his word in your life. The Bible says here, and Joseph was a goodly person and well favored. A very good person. So good that his master left his estate, the management of his affairs, into the hands of Joseph. And the Bible says he was not taking account of anything. All he knew was only the food he was eating. As the business yielding, Joseph was paying things into his account. And every day he was receiving a lot. Things were moving. Joseph knew when to stock and knew how to sell. Everything was going well. Little did he know that the faithfulness shown in the house of the master, God was seeing everything and God was nodding his head. Yes, I didn't make mistake. I chose the right person. This one will fulfill my purpose in Israel. God was nodding his head. Oh yes, oh yes, oh yes. Even when things were going bad and worse in the life of Joseph, God was monitoring, because he had the pointers that will make him fulfill the dream of heaven. This morning, God will see the same in your life. I didn't hear your amen very well. Number one, Psalm 37:4 says, delight yourself in the Lord. Delighting yourself in the Lord means love him. Love him with all your heart. Love him with all your strength. Love him with all that you are. Love him. Let there be nothing you are keeping away from God. Love him. Some of us cannot give our first fruit to God because we love money more than God. God will test you. He will give you opportunity and see what you will do with that opportunity. Whether you are going to think that is the best you can ever be in life, so let me hold it. He will test you. God has never put anyone in position that he never tested. He tested them all. He tested Abraham. He tested everyone that he ever lifted up before he lifted them. They passed the test. May you pass your own. Delight yourself in him. Let me say again, this is a down payment. When you love God and you love him well and you're walking in his will, you have already paid your bills ahead. Number two, consistency in our walk with God. Consistency in our walk with God. You will see that with Joseph. In his father's house, working with God. He came to Egypt, Potiphar's house. He increased. They sent him to prison. It didn't mean anything. To that point, the warders became less busy because this young man knew how to control situation. Everywhere, he was found faithful. And when Pharaoh needed somebody to help him out of his problem, Joseph became the one that got there. Today, you may not look like somebody who will be a president in Nigeria. But I want to say to you, there is a way you walk with God, he will prepare you. And when the time comes, it's the people that will come and carry you. I said it in the church, and I said the time has come that people here should become ministers of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. Oh, I didn't hear you well. And God will work it out. We will call you for celebration one of these days. I didn't hear your amen very well. We have paid the dues. Consistent walk. Consistent walk. When you are consistent in your walk, you will behave like Joseph. You will not participate in the evil, not evil of your brothers and sisters. You separate. That's consistency. You are not hot today, tomorrow you are cold. You are on fire for God and you are not compromising. That's what God is looking for. And when God sees that, he is going to bring about restoration. Please maintain a broken relationship with him this year. And you will find peace. You will find satisfaction. You will find fulfillment in the Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ. God tested Abraham. He said, offer your son for me. In Genesis 22. And Abraham said, it's okay. I've never known you to be interested in human sacrifice. If this is one of your ways of testing me, I will pass this test. And he went with his boy. Got to the mountain, prepared the altar, jacked him, landed him on the altar, tied him up, and brought out the knife to slaughter him. And God stopped him in verse 12 and said, now I know that you love me. God will ordain strength because of the enemy when he sees that you love him. The Bible says there is no want to those who love God. Number three, because of my time, set your priorities right. I have a whole message on this. Set your priorities right. In setting your priorities right, you must be a dreamer. Not only a dreamer, you must be organized. Many of us are not organized at all. That's the reason why you put capital in business. At the end of the day, both the capital and the profit gone, you cannot go back to market. The other day we went to buy this speaker and we tried to beat down the price. And the man said to us, if it were before, I could sell at that price. But now, because of the rate of naira to the dollar, if I sell this thing for you at the price you are giving me, I cannot go to market again because I will not have enough to buy. Therefore, I am selling this at the price I will be able to go back to market again. You see some people, they are so busy, but at the end of the day, nothing to write home. Why? They are not organized. And you know, when you put the last thing first, instead of the first thing first, failure has taken place already. Be a dreamer. Be organized. Then have direction. Have a goal. What direction are you going? When John the Beloved was sitting close to Jesus, every meeting he would look for where Jesus is sitting, he would go and sit near. He graduated from sitting near Jesus to leaning on Jesus. Was it that he had no backbone? Why was he leaning on Jesus? Physically, he was saying, rub on me your personality. Rub on me who you are. Rub on me everything. Do you know? When Jesus came to the Sea of Tiberias and he said, Peter, lovest thou me more than this? And Peter said, yes. He said, feed my lambs. Lovest thou me more than this? Peter said, yes, I love you. He said, feed my sheep. Lovest thou me more than this? Peter, why not? Only me. Lovest thou. He said, yes, Lord, you know I love you. He said, feed my sheep. Then he said, but this man that is always very close to you, you can't afford to forget him now. What will this man do? He said, leave him. I know what I will give him. It's not your business. You face your own, he will face his own. Let me say this to you. I beg you. I am begging you. Have direction. Have focus. If there is no direction and you are not organized, you cannot stay focused. That's the reason why you see somebody in January, he says, I am selling materials. By June, he has moved to foodstuff. By October, he has moved to building materials. Hello? At the end of the year, he will say, I didn't see restoration. You are not organized. You are not focused. There is no dream you are living to fulfill. Anything goes is what you are doing. But I pray, God, this day, something will change in you in Jesus' name. Number four, match your prayers with actions. Match your prayers with actions. Jesus said, in Luke 6, 46, he said, why are you calling me Lord, Lord, and you do not the things which I say? Match your prayers with action. We pray so much in this church, but only God knows what you do in the secret. When you pray, you are building with one hand. But when your attitude is negative, you are pulling down with the other hand. But when you pray, you are building with one hand and you have the right attitude, positive attitude, you are building also with the other hand, and progress will come. So I want to encourage you, match prayer with action. Every one of us, do not only write covenant requests, also write action plan. Hello? Next Sunday, we are collecting your requests from you. Give us only requests, but the one you are having as your copy include what? Action plan. Prayer without action is not complete, because Jesus said, watch as you do what? Talk to me now. So it's very important that corresponding action to prayer is part of what we are doing. Those are pointers. And number five, serve, or let me make it this way, service delivery. You must be characterized by faithfulness and diligence. Like Joseph, faithfulness and diligence. In Ephesians 6, Paul told the church, every servant should be faithful, not eye service. Service delivery. If every one of us in the church will be putting in our best, the way the choir put in their best. They had many rehearsals before today's service. So that they can present their best. They came very early to reorganize. So that they can present their best. Brothers and sisters, be your best. Do your best. Do your best. Be like Isaac. God said, I will bless you. Remain in this land, I will bless you. And he started planting on dry ground. He said, that's what I know how to do. That's what I'm doing. God said, he will bless me. And everybody was surprised that no rain, yet what he planted started germinating and bearing fruit until he became greater than all the people around him. This year, God will lift you up. Rise up and be a preacher. Preach to somebody. Say, neighbor. Okay, change it. Say, brother. If you are not by brother, call her by, say, sister. Say, brother, this year, God shall make you greater than all your neighbors. Do you believe it? I believe it. I went for house dedication. One pastor dedicating house yesterday, and I ministered. When I was praying, I prayed for him. I said, you will do greater one, more than every other. And who are the every other? I was there. So if he's going to do more than every other, I was there. Praise God. We must not be jealous. Because the way you are lifting up, that's how you are lifting yourself. So don't be jealous if I call you for my house dedication tomorrow. Because I have blessed somebody. I've wished somebody well. And with all my heart. Look at your neighbor again. Say, neighbor. This year, God shall make you greater than all your neighbors. Can I hear a better amen? A glorious amen. Number six. Be a person of courage and integrity. A person of courage and integrity. Words will fail me here, but I want you to please know there are occupational hazards. Every soldier, the day he enters the army and he takes the uniform, he will sign that he's ready to die for the nation. Am I correct? That's his occupational hazard. But me, I didn't sign that. Every doctor and every nurse, they know that during this time of coronavirus, they must work. Am I correct? They must treat people. Even if what is the worst form of corona, they must treat them. And in the process, many doctors are dying, nurses are dying. That's the occupational hazard. Therefore, any field you choose, there are hazards. Therefore, you must be courageous. Let me hear you say, I will be courageous. Some people thought that pastoral work is the easiest work to do. Let me tell you, some have run away. I, standing before you, there was a time I felt like running away. Because human being has problems. You must have courage and then integrity, integrity, integrity. When Pharaoh told Joseph about his dream, even with divine information coming to Joseph, it requires courage to speak. And say, Pharaoh, there will be 7 years of famine, and there will be another 7 years of plenty. If we take care of the years of plenty very well, the years of famine will be forgotten. But if we fail to take care very well of the years of plenty, the years of famine will come, and nobody will remember that anything good has ever passed through this land. He took courage, because the years will come and go. And as he said, that was how it came to pass. It takes courage. Somebody said, nothing good comes easy. If you want to be the best, one, be courageous, and be a man or woman of integrity. To the point, Pharaoh said to his people, can we find a man like this man? Is there anybody like this man? Before Pharaoh were all his nobles. Before Pharaoh were all the magicians of Egypt. Before Pharaoh were all the priests of the different gods. And he said, can we find any man like this one? Because this one has the spirit of the excellent God. And everyone said, no. See what he said now. Who can do? None of us can declare that. And that was how the promotion of Joseph came. Integrity will lift you up. Do not cut corners. Do not get yourself involved with dirty business. Do not get involved. If you are in position, do not take bribe. Clean your hands, clean your life. Live for God and tell God, I am living for you because I believe you can promote me. I am living for you because I know you will provide. And the Lord will surprise you in the name of Jesus Christ. Therefore, carry honor, dignity, respect with you. Be a trustworthy brother, a trustworthy sister. Reputable and dependable. Let people be comfortable dealing with you because you are always transparent. And number 7, the ability to wait for God. This year you will wait for God. Paul said, having done all to stand, wait for God. And my joy this morning is to tell you that God will not come late. I say God will not come late. God will not allow you to fail. He will see to it that everything work well with you in the name of Jesus Christ. Somebody is asking me, why must I wait for God? You have to wait for him. The Bible said, they that wait for God shall renew what? Their strength. They will mount up. He didn't say they will go there. He said they will mount up. Wait for God. Why must I wait for God? Ephesians 3:20 says, unto him that is able to do exceedingly abundantly, more than we ask or think. God is able. God is able. So wait for him. After doing all that you know you should do, wait for him. That was what Joseph did. He waited for God. He was not in a hurry. He waited for God. And at the appropriate time, God came. When it would be very useful. When his service would turn to blessing, God came. And everything turned around in his life. By the grace of God, this year, restoration will be possible in Jesus' name. What are the pointers? Rise up and talk to me now. Number 1, delight yourself in the Lord. Number 2, consistency in our work with God. Number 3, set your priorities right. What did I say under setting your priorities right? Be a dreamer. Be organized. Have direction. Say focus. Praise God. Number four, match your prayers with actions. Number five, service delivery. What did I say there? Let faithfulness characterize everything you do. And as you do that, God will show up in the name of Jesus. Stand for excellence. Add that to it. Excellence. Do it well. I think it was Professor Jerry Gana when he was in Mamsa. If you are praying, what did he say? If you are organizing, what did he say? Everything well, 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 well. Do it well. Excellence. If you go to buy akara, for example, and you saw the woman frying akara, she would turn it and use her hand to put the thing on the fire. In the same place, her child was poo-pooing, and she was using the same hand to take water and wash the poo-poo from the bottom. And after washing the poo-poo, use the same hand, pack the akara, put for fire. Will you see by? Excellence. So you will see people travel from Gariki to Wuse to go and buy what they will eat because they have confidence in that person. Excellence. Organization. Number what now? Number six. Courage and dignity. Now number seven. Will you wait for God? If you are in a hurry, you will miss God. But wait for Him. God's time, they tell us, is the best. Now open your Bible to Psalm 20. Psalm 20. From verse 1. Are we there? We are reading all together. Three, go. The Lord hear thee in the day of trouble. I didn't hear your amen to that. Okay, I change. Now you'll be saying amen as I read. The Lord hear thee in the day of trouble. The name of the God of Jacob defend thee. God will hear you in the day of trouble when you are walking in line with the pointers to restoration. The eyes of the Lord moving to and fro. He wants to show himself strong. And his eyes was following Joseph. Following Joseph. And when the eyes of God was following Joseph, the eyes of God left these other ones. Because they didn't have what it takes for God's eyes to be on them. Eventually, where Joseph was prospered and became the number one nation, like America is number one now in the world. Everybody wants to go to America. Everybody wants to touch dollar. That was how Egypt was. Because Joseph was there and the place he left, where they said, if you are here, you will rule over us. We push you out. The people then now started coming to where he was to look for survival. I pray for you. Anywhere you find yourself, this year will be the best. The very best. In the name of Jesus Christ. Wait for God. The people that said we will not bow, when they eventually discovered the MD, the CEO, who is in charge of food sales in Egypt, if he didn't approve, nobody can buy. They discovered he was their brother. Joseph didn't need to talk. On their own, they went down. And they said, we are your servants. But it took them years to realize that. And it cost them years to push Joseph to go through unnecessary sufferings. That's why we pray the prayers we prayed before. Every suffering you have gone through that was not necessary, but because people are fighting your destiny, this year is the end. Let's go back. Psalm 20, verse 1. The Lord heard thee in the day of trouble. The name of the God of Jacob defend thee. Verse 2. Send thee help from the sanctuary and strengthen thee out of Zion. Verse 3. Remember all thy offerings and accept thy burnt sacrifice. Grant thee according to thy own heart. That's why your covenant request is important, because you are presenting your heart before God. Grant thee according to thine own heart and fulfill all thy counsel. Let me tell you something. Hey, God, give me anything. Just as you gave to brother, give me also. He knows your capacity. God will not waste resources. He will give you according to your capacity. That's why be pleased with the level you are, because God has seen your capacity. He will take you higher tomorrow as you progress. That's why you must be organized. You must stay focused. Be a dreamer. Grant thee according to thy own heart and fulfill all thy counsel. Verse 5. We will rejoice in thy salvation. And in the name of our God, we will set up our banners. The Lord fulfill all thy petitions. Now know I that the Lord saveth his anointed. He will hear him from his holy heaven with the saving strength of his right hand. Some trust in chariots and some in horses, but we will remember the name of the Lord our God. They are brought down and fallen, but we are risen and stand upright. Save, Lord. Let the king hear us when we call. Let the king hear us when we call. Let our God hear us when we call. God will hear us. He said, my ears are not deaf. My hands are not shut. If you fulfill your part, I will fulfill my part. And if what it takes is what I've shared with you, keep to them, and by the grace of God, your day of rejoicing has come. A songwriter wrote, he said, he changed my morning into dancing again. He lifted my sorrow. I can't keep silent. Are you waiting for joy, or it has come? Well, you have the key. You know you will not struggle to enter your house. You have gotten the key. You will not struggle. You will see God. Your joy must come in the name of Jesus Christ. Lift up your hands and give him glory. Thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Bring out your covenant request forms. The Lord will hear you as you call. Hallelujah. 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 For the Lord God Almighty reigns. Is a miracle. When you pray with the heart of joy, with the heart of faith, with the heart that is broken for God, the doors open. Hallelujah. 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 Is very near. Another one said, Jesus is passing this way. Is your heart broken? Is your heart pain? He is passing this way today. He wants to leave his blessing behind. Be like who cried, Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on me. He was supposed to be a Jew, a worshiper of Jehovah, but he found himself in a predicament. No priest could help him when he heard of Jesus. Just like we're hearing Jesus today, he said today must be the end. And that day was the end. Please, Jesus is passing by. Stop him. Say, Lord, see my requests. See my requests. None of them will fall to the ground. Clothe me with their answers. Bring your glory into my life with their answers. Steal the enemy as you answer me, and I will not hold back the testimony in the big congregation in the name of Jesus Christ. Make it your prayer. He is passing by. Let him stop by your side. There were many passing by that day, moving that day, talking that day. Jesus did not hear them, but he has Bartimaeus, because he shouted loudest. He shouted with intents. He shouted because of purpose. In Jesus' name we pray. Wave it. You are worthy, O Lord. You are worthy, O Lord, invisible God.
You're a miracle worker.
Say he is worthy. Just lift it up. He's worthy. He's a miracle worker. The Yoruba version says, "Enita orita anrisho wore." We cannot see you, but we see what you are doing. That's the God we are talking about. We shall see what he will do in your life. In the name of Jesus. He has done it for others. He will do your own. If they told you that there is no cure for the problem in your body, he is worthy. Invisible God, the miracle worker. Let him touch you this morning. Take away that trouble. In the name of Jesus. The woman cried, "My daughter is vexed with the devil." Every crying woman in this church this morning, the Lord wipe away your tears with miracle. The Lord wipe away your tears with miracle. In the name of Jesus. You were supposed to be rich, but some people are shining with your star. In the name of borrow me, but they will never give you back. All your money, they are outside. If you were having them, you will be called among the rich. But they are outside. And the people are not willing to pay you. Some of them, you don't even know where they are. I pray for you this morning. All your debtors, wherever they are, Holy Ghost, catch them. Holy Ghost, draw them. Holy Ghost, bring them to you. Let them come and pay. In the name of Jesus. I proclaim over you this morning, recover all. Recover all. Let there be restoration. In the name of Jesus. Before we came in here, the devil didn't desire you come. He was afraid because he knew you will get the secrets that will put key in your hand. Now you have gotten the key. You are unstoppable. You are unstoppable. You are unstoppable. In the name of Jesus. All those who were glorying in your glory, somebody said your head is too strong. Since you will not give them chance, you will not enjoy that place. And it has been turbulent. But I decree this morning, your enemies carry their trouble with their head. They carry their troubles with their head. In the name of Jesus. The families that are asking God for children, God has not stopped fertilizing his children. So I pray that this morning there be a gentle touch upon you from God. Holy Ghost, take over. Carry out the work of grace. This year, carry your pregnancy. If you are pregnant in February, you can still carry the baby this year. Even in March, you can still carry the baby this year. So these 2 months that can register this joy, let them not pass you by. In the name of Jesus. Amen. January is ending. February is coming in. All along every evening, we're coming to pray, coming to pray, coming to pray. And you were very happy. When we enter February, the temple will not go down in your life. So that all the enemies that are saying January will soon be over, they will stop. It's a lie. You'll be hotter than hot. In the name of Jesus Christ. And the covenant requests in your hands, I decree, they have turned into miracles. Your requests are turned into miracles. They have turned into blessings. They have turned into testimonies. In the name of Jesus. He has changed your money into dancing again. You will not be able to keep quiet because the joy will be too much. In the name of Jesus Christ. Your happiest year ever up until now shall be 2021. Shall be 2021. Shall be 2021. Coronavirus will not know our doorsteps. Will not touch our bodies. Terrorists, bandits, gunmen, kidnappers shall be far away from us. Holy Ghost! Holy Ghost! Holy Ghost! And because we are praying, there shall be peace in Nigeria. There shall be peace in Nigeria. Let God work a miracle that even beyond the government, the peace that will come, everybody will be surprised. In the name of Jesus! Every evil power in this nation, we break them. We destroy them. In the name of Jesus. All our leaders shall be responsible. They will fulfill purpose. They will serve us as good servants. In the name of Jesus Christ. And to the glory of God, the hands you are lifting up shall not go down without abundance. Poverty is far from us. Poverty is far from us. Prosperity has come to us. Favor has come to us. Progress has come to us. In the name of Jesus. So shall it be. That our joy will be full. I will not jealous you. You will not jealous me. Because as you are laughing, I am laughing. As you are smiling, as I'm smiling. As you are testifying, I'm testifying. It shall go round. In the name of Jesus Christ. If there is any special book called the Book of God's Favored Children, you have entered that book today. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, my Father. And every one of us, we fear God. We will run from sin. We will hate every evil work. We will separate ourselves to God like Joseph of old. And to the glory of God, our time will speak. And that time is when? Now. Because you believe, go with it. Run with it and see the glory of God. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, in Jesus' name we pray. To God.
Amen.